today we will do the last topic of chapter water, storage of water. So before moving on to this topic, we will revise water cycle. So there are four steps of water cycle: evaporation, transpiration, condensation and precipitation. This is a diagram which I have sent you in the notes, and I told you to understand the concept of water cycle. Now what happens? The sun heats up the water from river, lakes and wells, and the water is converted into water vapor by the process of evaporation. Transpiration. The leaves, as we know that the plant loses water in the form of water vapor, and this leaves, and from this leaves into the air, and this process is known as transpiration. Condensation. Now what happens, when the water vapor rises up, it starts cooling, okay, and form tiny droplets. When the tiny droplets come together to form a clouds, and this process is known as condensation. What happened in precipitation? After that, what happened? When the cloud starts getting heavier, okay, it cannot hold water droplets, and then it fall back on the earth in the form of rain, hail and snow. After that, some of the water that seeps into the ground, and that water is available in the form of underground water, and the remaining water, what happened to the remaining water? They go back in the lake, rivers and wells, and this process is known as collection. Again this cycle circulate, the sun start heating up the water, and this circulation is known as water cycle. Now we will study about storage of water. Okay, as we learned already that water is a valuable substance. Water has important role in our life. It should be used carefully. It means that it should not be wasted. We should not waste water. We can store the rainwater and reuse. How can we do that? How can we store rainwater? We can store rainwater in a large tank, or we can dig a pit in the backyard of our house. Now, if I say we have stored rainwater, okay? We have stored rainwater, and now I will ask you how you will use that rainwater in your activities. Tell me, how can we use rainwater? We can use rainwater in outdoor activities, like we can water the plants, we can clean our vehicles. This rainwater can be used for drinking also, but after filtration we can drink that water. Now if I ask you one question, why do we store water? We store water for future use. First is, we store water for future use. We store water if suppose there is scarcity of water, there is no supply of water, if the water is not available in a locality. So for that time we store water. Now if I ask you about the containers, okay, where you will store water, okay, we will store water in many containers, like a big drums, okay, like we have big containers in our house. In that we can store water. So this is a chapter about water, as water is very important in our life. We have studied about how can we use water. Okay, we can use water in many activities. Now after that we have studied about water cycle. Okay, and today we have studied about storage of water, and if we store that water, how can we use that water, and how can we use rainwater. So this is all about water. We have completed this chapter. Now from tomorrow onwards, we will do the exercise of this chapter. Meanwhile, read and understand the notes which I had given you and understand the concept of water.